Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala asyrafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. We are still discussing on the 6P of how we are going to develop our personal, our social, our societal and civilizational development in terms of the 6P that we're discussing, and how with this framework of how we develop our personal, social, societal, civilizational to create a holistic, just and peaceful and happy world for all, and how this is based on our heart-based intuitive feelings, which was not covered in the earlier models of multiple intelligence by Professor Howard Gardner. So I explained to you that the multiple intelligences of the model in which we see in psychology, even up to today, for those atheistic psychologists, they would only say that we have, all right, bodily kinesthetic, musical intelligence, visual spatial intelligence, verbal and logical. And we have this intra and interpersonal capacity or intelligences. So, but they would not go to the another level where, for example, we have naturalistic intelligences, and then at the highest level we have intuitive heart-based intelligences, which is now a lot of these psychologists who are embracing this global worldview of this universal worldview of this universe as an entity created by a supreme being. They call them the supreme universe or the supreme energy, whatever they want to call it, but it is God, Allah. And for us, they have embraced this, that these intuitive heart-based intelligences and our existential spiritual intelligences are the basis of our very existence. If not, our whole societal and civilizational framework will not be based on any meaning or purpose. If we say that we have within ourselves our intrapersonal, all right, internally we can reflect about our life. Internally we can make a decision, introspective, for those who intrapersonal. Within yourself, you introspect, you look at the things around you, you seek for a meaning and purpose, you are introvertly dealing with yourself. That means that's an intelligences. But to where, to whom, and how, and why, it cannot be answered. So that's why there is this very severe dichotomy between this message and our interpersonal intelligences together with the naturalistic, existential, spiritual and intuitive intelligences. Because if you deny this, then you deny actually the reality of your very existence. Who are you in this earth is a perennial question of humanity since the day we are created. Since Adam alayhi salam, Allah has given us the framework that Adam or Adam, the first human being, and Hawa or Eve, the wife and the progeny of all this species called human being, Homo sapiens, have a purpose and meaning. Allah created us introspectively to realize that we are His representative on earth, His Khalifa on this earth. So introspectively, we have an answer within the framework of Islam, the framework for a spiritual existence, and the framework for this intuitive heart-based intelligences. Because we are not just a purely material being, we live and then die, and that's the end of the story. We live, but we have a pre-existent. That means our existence in the spiritual realm, in the realm of Azali. We have that, and we live in this world. And we will not die, actually, in Islam. Death is only a movement from one level of existence to another level of existence. So as a result, the idea of this intuition, heart-based, and spiritual intelligence must be infused in every child, every human being in the world today. Other than that, what do we have? We have this idea of escapism, that the whole industrial base or the base of our internet and our online and our lifestyle is based on escaping. Why do we have video games? Because people are bored to death. They are bored. So what do? You give them video games. Slay the Dragon, Tetris for the old ones and the new ones. And also you just lose time. You just sit down. Why? To escape. Why do you have Hollywood? Why do you have Bollywood? Why do you have, for example, pornography, online pornography? Why do you have melodramas, thousands and thousands and thousands of all kind of languages? It is a form of escapism. That means this civilization, if we just carry on that trend, will not give us a deeper meaning. And to numb our existence of the perennial questions of our spiritual existence and intuitive heart-based intelligences that Allah has endowed upon us, we numb ourselves with this ghafla, this forgetfulness, because the trend of civilization today is to make you forget about your very existence and dish you out food to the extent you become fat and you die by being fat, all right? Or videos, or television shows, or social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, WeChat, YeChat, you name it, everything under the sun. Why? To make us a creature that forget our very existence, our very meaning, our very purpose in life. So we should not be like that. So Muslims have the most logical, most intrinsic question to the answer to that question, that it is rational, logical, and acceptable, and proven. Proven from where? Proven from the new sciences that we are talking about. So if our forefathers is talking about the realization of God through Ilmu Kalam, learning about Wujud, Qidam, Baqa, and so on, and the sifa of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the wajib sifa and the impossible sifa, that was based on the outcome of the Muslim interaction in facing the philosophical argument of those times. Today, we Muslims, we have the not only the philosophical argument, but also the scientific basis for us to go at another level. And for that, we have to accept the fact that we are not having only the seven intelligences, and our model must include the intrapersonal, interpersonal, naturalistic, accidental spiritual intelligences, and most important, intuitive, heart-based intelligences, because this will be the foundation for a holistic civilization, which we Muslims can promote to the world, so that we can have a balance. If every human being is living in a hedonistic, meaningless, purposeless life of just eat, sleep, sex, fun, play, what will be the outcome? It is an aimless, purposeless life that leads to self-destruction, that leads to addiction, that leads to all kinds of problems that will not bring peace, happiness, or success. But the other model that we have, of based on our love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, relying on His mercy, His compassion, and relying on this whole great purpose of existence, being His Khalifa on this earth, and relying on the intuitive intelligences, nurturing it as part of our existence. You can feel it within yourself, and this has been elaborated throughout the history of Islam. I mean, the greatest of this story is the story of all the prophets of Allah. If you read all the stories, they are living on what? Intuitive skills, intuitive intelligence, spiritual intelligences, which was abounded by them. And the best of all is our Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the beloved of Allah and our beloved, who received the revelation. Where does the revelation come from? It comes from the realm of the Creator to us, the Quran, and it explains many, many things from the existence, the purpose of our existence. So all these things will then strengthen our intrapersonal, interpersonal, naturalistic, existential, spiritual, and intuitive heart intelligences, because Allah tells us, from the perspective of our heart base, how we are going to change ourselves based on the love of Allah, love of the Prophet, and how we realize that we have to have mercy and compassion, receiving it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and transmitting it to all humanity. The mercy, the compassion, and the love of Allah to all humanity. And we develop a wonderful, holistic, future civilization based on iman and taqwa, based on realizing our purpose and meaning in life, and based on understanding the fulfillment of all our intelligences. So when I'm talking about Professor Howard Gardner intelligences, we now can develop a better model, multiple intelligences, holistic PIP model. Inshallah, there will be a lot of research. For example, we talk about the interaction of intrapersonal, interpersonal, naturalistic, existential, intuitive intelligence, where are they from? Naturally, the intersection come from our roh, our spirit. The interaction come from our kal. The interaction also come from our kal. The interaction also come from our nafs and our jasad. So basically, it is this holistic principle that is so wonderful and is so amazing. And remember, this is very, very, very scientific. So if anybody is going to deny the intuitive heart-based intelligences, they're going to deny about the very purpose of our life. So if we are able to do that, we are able to understand, for example, the revelation that our Holy Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is an inspiration from the realm of the Creator. Allah infused through Jibreel to him to bring this message. We have the revelation to Prophet Jesus, to Moses, to all the great teachers, maybe even Buddha and Lao Tzu and Confucius and other great teachers of the world. Allah sent prophets to all humanity, all time, all tribes. So we have that. And this intuitive heart-based intelligences can be proven. Even within the realm of all the miracles of our Holy Prophet Muhammad and Khalifa Rashidun, for example, Sayyidina Umar, Umar al-Khattab, at one time was giving his khutbah in the Grand Mosque of Medina for Friday prayer. And then while he was giving his khutbah, suddenly he says, out of context, he says, Sariya, Sariya, run up to the hill, run up to the hill. And everybody in the congregation was shocked. So after the Friday prayer, they asked Sayyidina Umar al-Khattab, why do you say so? Then he says, I foresaw Sariya was a commander of the Muslim army that was being attacked by the Persians. And he told Sariya to go up the hill. And the miracle is that Sariya heard that message and brought the army up the hill. And when the Persian came, they defeated because they were at the upper level. And this is where it comes from. Where it comes from? This intuitive heart-based intelligences. It is beyond the physical matter, and this is where we can nurture, because we have our framework within the spiritual adab, the spiritual knowledge intact in Islam. Maybe in other traditions, maybe in Buddhism, maybe in Christianity, maybe in Hinduism, they have this spiritual tradition. We're not denying, because all religions have spiritual tradition, but the most beautiful, the most intact, the most accurate of a worldview that you can embrace is this embracement of this intuitive heart-based intelligence that is based on love, that is based on mercy, that is based on compassion from Allah to us, and diffuse it to all humanity. And when you do that, we Muslims will rise. The moment Muslims disregard this, we base our religion on revenge, hate, and killings, we will lose ourselves. We will lose our dignity. We will lose everything. And we will become downtrodden to become the worst of the worst in this world. So we have to reclaim our position in life. And inshallah, if we understand how, even from the very basic principle tools of psychology, from the work of Professor Howard Gardiner, we can tell that Islam has a better model. But it's up to you, brothers and sisters, those of you who are psychologists, who are neurologists, who are studying human potential, human capacity, to come up with an answer to this. I can only give you an overview for you to understand that the holistic civilization can be led by Muslims in the 21st and 22nd century, and we would bring them the joy, the meaning, the purpose, the love, the grace, the mercy, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to all of us as Muslims, and to all human beings and all goodly creatures on this planet Earth, so that we fulfill our role as His Khalifa, always striving to make ourselves good, helping others to be good, and making the world good, inshallah.